Oh, that's quite important. Okay, so yeah, basically we would like to solve the overwhelm that is caused by many metadata standards and select the few that are most important in my field of research. And actually, I'm going to tell two stories today. First, I'm going to explain an approach that I use to define a set of metadata that is useful in my community. And the second part of the talk is a demonstration of how we use this to improve the automatic capture of provenance, because ultimately we don't want the bioinformatic practitioners that run the workflow and are concerned with biology to have to worry about, did I really share my data correctly? Did I actually capture all the details that are necessary? So we really want to focus on automatic capture. And in that part of the talk, I'm going to explain ROCRAID to you. One approach to define useful metadata in a community is to do an evaluation or analysis of all the workflows that exist in that community. It is possible to do this, but it requires a lot of work. And also, you mostly don't get all the details of every computation. So instead, what I did was I used one workflow that I knew very well because I was working with this workflow. And I analyzed that particular workflow in detail. And I assumed, and my colleagues agreed with me, that this workflow already represented a lot of the problems that we commonly encounter. And basically, what we did for this workflow was to identify a set of realistic provenance questions that are very likely to be asked at some point of the workflow's lifetime. Before we could get there, provenance questions only make sense if in a particular situation. So what we also did was we associated them with particular use case scenarios. And this was sort of an iterative process. And in the end, we arrived at a list of questions which could relate to the data sets that were used as an input, for example, the file format. They could relate to the software that was part of the workflow, for example, the version. We also asked questions like, which publications should I actually cite when I use a particular input data set? But also questions about the execution of the workflow. So how much memory do I actually need when I want to re-execute this step? And do I actually have the computational power to re-execute this? Or for example, what are the details about the software container that was used to execute a particular step? We had this list of questions. What it is next was I identified all the metadata that was required to sufficiently answer the provenance questions. The next step was to run my workflow in a special provenance mode called CWL-Prov. And then I went back to the output of the workflow and saw how much of this required metadata was actually stored and preserved after workflow execution. And for the missing information, I then went back and thought about how I could represent this best in the workflow. In my case, I used a common workflow language, and the CWL standards actually allow you to annotate the input data. But what I did not do yet was to specify which ontologies to use to do this in a consistent way. What I did, I don't have time today to explain this in detail, but I set up a set of guidelines for my colleagues to help them add the required metadata to their inputs. And if you're interested, there's a preprint online which you can use in which I described it in a bit more detail. Okay, so this is the end of the first part of the presentation. So to summarize, what we did was I described an approach in which you analyze a single workflow in your community to identify a set of useful metadata, and subsequently thought about how to best represent this metadata in the workflow language the way of describing your workflows that you normally use. However, as I mentioned before, this is not the ultimate goal. The ultimate goal is to to have automatic capture of provenance metadata, because we want to execute workflows on workflow systems who record all the necessary details during execution. And the first step, or one of the important steps that we need before we can get there, is that we need to have a standard to represent the metadata in a machine accessible format. And this is how where ROCreate comes in. ROCreate is a standard to package research data together with metadata in a machine accessible format. ROCreate has multiple specializations, or profiles as we call them. And I was part of the workflow run ROCreate group, and we wanted to adjust or specialize the generic ROCreate specification to store details about workflow executions. And what this looks like is, you can see on the right part of the slide. So it's ROCreate, you can think about as a kind of box or crate that stores all your data and metadata. In the case of the workflow run profile, it stores all the data, which is input and output data, and the workflow associated with the analysis. And there's also a provenance metadata file in RDF, which means it's machine accessible and you can query it with a query language called Sparkle. And basically, this provenance metadata file describes all the stored data entities and also the relations between them. And it does that using schema.org ontology. And where my contribution in this project came in was because we wanted to evaluate the provenance that was stored in the profile and to assess if it actually fulfilled, like how it related to the set of metadata that we defined before. So what I did was I divided the collection of metadata into 6 categories, and then I looked for every category how it was represented in ROCreate. And doing this, we found some gaps, and like some elements we were able to fix. So we improved the specification based on the evaluation. And the other outcome of the analysis was that we knew next steps to, we knew basically what we should be working on in the future. The first point that I want to highlight is that we really need to focus on capturing specific information automatically, because there's a lot of data, metadata related to the input data, for example, that is probably very accessible to the workflow system and could be stored and captured, for example, during download of the data. So instead of just downloading the data set from the database, we would like to also capture the metadata that was associated with this data. There's also another more conceptual challenge, and that is that at the moment, it's not very clear how we can represent the computational system that executed the workflow. So it's not just capturing the details about this system, but it's also that it's at this moment there's no consensus about how we want to represent this information. So if anybody is really interested in working with this, please join the ROCreate community, because we think this is a really important direction to work on. This brings me to the end of my talk. Hopefully, I've convinced you in this talk that provenance metadata is important, but also that to arrive at a good solution, it's really important that bioinformatics practitioners work together with developers of workflow systems and databases and developers of ROCreate. So if you also think that, how can you get involved? First of all, it could be really helpful to develop or to define a set of metadata standards for your community, or like the set of useful metadata. So what you can do is do the same exercise as what I did and make a list of provenance questions for a specific workflow in your domain. There's a preprint online which has more details than I could explain today. And Once you have this list of questions, I would also encourage you to identify which information you need to answer them, and not do this on your own, but please also ask advice from your local experts, or if they're not available, there's also the Research Data Alliance who can help you with choosing the right metadata standards and ontologies. And once you have your results, it would be really helpful to report it to the ArchiCrit community. And then if you're working on a workflow system or a database or another type of automatic workflow execution system, please join the ArchiCrit community as well, because we really welcome new perspectives in the discussion. And I would also like to ask you to think about how much of the metadata that I mentioned is already easily accessible for your workflow system. And then also consider how to store this in a machine accessible format using ArchiCrit. So with that, I would like to end this presentation and to thank all the groups that I was involved in. So that's the Workflow Run ArchiCrit Working Group, the VU Bioinformatics Group, and the Distributed Systems Group at the Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam. And I would like to thank you for your attention. So thank you.
Do we have any questions online?
Okay. Yes.
Thank you for your excellent talk. Can you just comment briefly? You kind of talked about how does this particular approach enable metadata sharing?
Do you mean, I assume you mean ArchiCrit? Okay.
How can you use it effectively to do metadata sharing amongst communities? You mentioned one community can adopt it, but one of the challenges in metadata is that it's usually community specific.
Yes.
Do you have any views on that given the perspective you presented?
Yes, it's a very good question, because consistency is really important. In principle, ArchiCrit is domain independent. So the generic ArchiCrit specification is applicable to many domains. What can happen though, and what is encouraged, is that individual communities develop specializations of the ArchiCrit profile, but in principle, they should still be at least in part compatible with each other. So I know the ArchiCrit is also implemented in Workflow Hub. It's a repository, and the idea is that once you publish an analysis, you upload the data as an ArchiCrit, and other people can then analyze the data again, because it is machine accessible. You could query over the whole database and find the specific workflow that you're interested in. That's one of the applications, I would say. So thank you. Yes.
Thank you. I was just curious about one of the aspects about accessing this metadata is, from a user's point of view, is being able to more easily see the information. So do you have in plans, or do you already have something that allows visualization of this information in a more user-friendly way that can help people understand it better?
It's definitely on my wish list. It's really important. I'm not sure if there are already people working on this, but it is definitely possible, because it's standardized way of representing information. So if it's not done already, it should definitely be done in the near future. So maybe Michael knows more about this.
So I can give a brief response to the two earlier questions about ArchiCrit and compatibility across communities. There's an emphasis on reusing schema.org for the most general things. And of course, you can always bring in your domain-specific ontologies and vocabularies. So we should share the things that are common and do things specific that are specific. That was a great question. It's definitely part of the philosophy. And there's much interest in visualizing, making attractive. So there's a really big community around ArchiCrit. This talk was more specific about the workflow run profile. And please learn more about that. And then, Rensky, as your supervisor, I'll ask two questions. For you,
it's defense,
these are friendly, it's okay. You listed a couple questions on the screen, but how many Providence questions did you come up with total?
Ooh, I don't know it from the top of, I guess it's at least 40.
Yeah, so the point here is you came up with quite a lot.
Yes.
And that's what made this much easier. They were grounded in your real experience. This is the big takeaway. We want people to, don't be afraid, be specific to what you already know.
Yes.
My second question would be, what was the biggest surprise in your analysis based on how you expected it to go from the beginning?
The biggest surprise in my analysis was that a lot of seemingly simple questions were not were difficult to answer. Because I mentioned it before, like in the talk, a lot of this information is already accessible to the workflow system because it downloads data from a database, and then the database has metadata, but the metadata is not retrieved or stored with the data. And this is a very relatively simple problem. It's not as complicated as like capturing the entire computational system. So that was for me a big surprise.